Byron Bay now is a very busy place. We have so many people from all over the world visiting us. So it's really important that we teach people to appreciate what we hold so dear to us. The Arakul people belong here in Byron Bay. Arakul's our language name, who we are, part of the Bunjalung nation. The true name of Byron Bay is Cavanbah, and Cavanbah means meeting place. Why it's a meeting place is we'd invite other Bunjalung people to come and share when food was in abundance. Marriages were set, resources were traded, and people would go back to their own country. Wolgan in our language means shoulder in Bunjalung, and Cape Byron's true name is Wolgan, and it's a place of initiation. So our young boys would be taken up to Wolgan to be initiated into manhood. We live in a place that's plentiful, you know. We're right on the beach, so we've got the fish and we've got all the sea life and we've got the bush. So we didn't really have a huge movement. The Brunswick River out the back of Possum Creek, Bangalow, over to 7 Mile Beach. That was our country and that's where we stayed. And we never took too much, just enough. And we always made sure that we give back to the land and, you know, we made sure there's plenty for the birds and the animals. And our people had a huge campsite just in town at Lawson Street, roundabout at the old council chambers. There was up to 200 of our people living here. So when Byron became populated, of course, our people were pushed out of town. Nan and Pop had 13 children and their first campsite was at the mouth of Tallows, right on the beach, because Aboriginal people weren't allowed in town. And it was really quiet. They had plenty of food. They were still living off the land, our people, and fishing out of the creek. Yeah, it was very safe living there. The dolphin is our totem of the Arakul women. We believe that once we leave the land, our spirit turns into the dolphin. So when you look out there and see the dolphin, that's my grandmother's and my auntie's and my mother out there. The men's totem is Miwin, the sea eagle. Yep. And he's, yeah, you always see him gliding around the cliffs, yep, looking for fish. He's our mighty hunter. The totem of our people is Kubul, the carpet snake. So other Bunjalung people know us as the carpet snake people. Julian Rocks is very significant for all Bunjalung, and there's many stories about Nothingali. So there's not just one story. It's our creator's place. It's where our creator rests. He created all that you can see. The mountains, the rivers, the valleys. That's Nothingali. And we're bound to look after country. In 2001, after 14 years of native title struggle, our elders were able to negotiate with government to protect country, and Arakul National Park was created, and that gives our people a great say in how we want to look after country. And using our elders' knowledge and wisdom, we can get country back to how it used to be and protect it. And it's a gift to the whole community, a gift that everyone can actually go and be on country, and it'll always be there. Otherwise, we'd be full of development, wouldn't we? I suppose we want our visitors, people who come from all over the world, to, you know, connect with country, appreciate it like we do, you know, stop, listen, feel, and just be a part of it. Not just come into town and drink, but to actually listen to nature and, yeah, listen to Mother Earth. Take a walk up the lighthouse and visit the cottage where, you know, you can watch a DVD about our people and you could look at the paintings and learn about our rich history that we have here. Byron Bay, to me, is where I belong. There's no word to describe how I feel about home. We're just part of this place and we're put here to look after this place. We're part of this place. Yeah. Byron Bay is us. We are Byron Bay. Yeah.